Robin, Shelley,
and Jen.
And today we're going to talk about our favorite go-to powders. And these powders are suitable for different skin types. So I have combination sensitive and acne-prone skin.
I'm just really oily.
I have dry skin to normal skin. So
yeah, if these work for us and we use them every day, then it probably should work for you too.
Okay, let's get started.
Okay,
so my favorite powders, I use two on a daily basis in different steps of my makeup routine. The first one is this one by Nikkia Joy Cosmetics. I don't know if you guys have watched Nikkia Joy, but I'm sure anyone who has oily skin out there kind of knows her. She's this Australian YouTuber and she has super oily skin. So then when she launched her own makeup line, well, cosmetics line, she had this finishing powder. She calls it a velvet finishing powder, but I use it more as like a setting powder. The color of it is kind of like nude. It's like skin tone color, Asian skin tone, I guess, like not every skin tone. It's like banana powder color. But when you apply it on the face, the color is not very strong. It's a very fine, loose powder. So I use my Shiseido brush and I dip the powder like directly like this. And then I will swirl it on the cap so that it like goes into the brush, and then I tap the excess off, and I don't swipe it on my face because I don't want to move my foundation or concealer. So what I do is I take the brush and I pat it on where will be oily on my face, so especially around the T-zone. And I also put it on my under eyes to set my concealer. I do this kind of before I put on my eyeshadow and everything else.
Oh, what?
And then yeah, because then if I put it before my eyeshadow, then my eyeshadow, like if it falls on like my under eye, I can sweep it off easily.
Right.
After I put on blush and bronzer and everything, I will go in with the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder in Dim Light. I'm currently using this like travel size because I want to try out this shade first, but I really like it. I'm going to repurchase when I'm like almost done. This is really good. It's exactly my skin tone.
Oh.
But it's not for everyone. Hourglass has a few of these lighting, what do you call it? They call it ambient lighting powders, and they have it in a bunch of tones. They have some that are more warm, more cool, more brightening. This one is more of like a natural finish that suits my skin tone. But yeah, I sweep this all over my face and I swirl it, and it's really good for blending in bronzer and blush and just making everything look more seamless. Like you don't want to look really, really flat. So this is really good because it does have like a bit of like a luminous effect. And if you want to skip highlighter, it's completely fine. You can just put this all over your face and it looks more natural and glowing.
So my go-to powder is the Laura Mercier, and this is the translucent one. So I've been actually using
this. Wait, there's another one?
They have like a light, dark, and tan one.
Oh.
But then I tend to not go for the ones with color. I like it translucent, so I don't know, it's just safer, you know?
Oh, yeah. None of our powders have any coverage, right?
No.
Yeah, mine doesn't.
Not any coverage. Yeah. But I have been literally going, this is probably my fifth or sixth tub. And I really like it because it's so fine. And it does have a bit of tint of color, like a really light beige. You can see in the product shot. But when you put it on it, there's no color at all. And it gives a really like soft, airy finish, like airbrush finish.
Mm,
it kind of blurs
important.
Out.
Yeah.
It blurs out my pores. It blurs out my dry lines and fine lines.
A good powder doesn't just mattify and flatten the face. Mm. It gives your face like a very natural finish.
Yes, it doesn't flatten my face. That's a really good term.
Mm.
I have really oily skin, so, and dehydrated skin, so combo. So I want something that would mattify my face, but at the same time, like they won't cling onto my dry patches, and this one doesn't. My face gets so oily throughout the day, and even if I use any kind of powder, like it's still gonna get oily. But at least this one can last long enough. It lasts me up to, I think, 6 hours. Also, it doesn't have a white cast.
You know what powder has a white cast? The RCMA. Yeah. Really
maybe
thick.
It's because we're Asian. We have yellow skin. That's why. We have a white cast when we use
but
the
I don't,
RCMA.
But we
but
have
I
like
have really light
generally
skin.
Fair skin
and
compared to like.
And it still looks white on me.
Yeah.
So I don't like to use a brush because I'm really scared to kind of like sweep
move.
Off my foundation or move my foundation, especially when I was dealing with acne. I was really careful about that. Yeah. So I just lightly like pat it on my face like this with a puff. God, my puff.
Maybe you can talk
see,
about how you clean your puff.
She doesn't.
I do, but then I do, but then because like my foundation also gets onto it.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So it's dirtier than it actually. It looks dirtier than it actually is.
Mm. How do you clean your puff?
I clean my puff with the beauty blender soap, in the liquid form, and I just like do this and like do this, and then I wait for it to dry overnight.
Using the original puff?
No. The original puff doesn't really fit the inside. It's like bigger. But this one kind of does, but I kind of just squish it in, you know, it doesn't fit entirely. Yeah, this puff is from Sekkisei, but what I really like about it is that it's super soft, and it doesn't have a lot of hair on it.
I noticed that it's like thin too.
Hairy, it's thin.
So you don't actually recommend people using the original?
I mean, the original is good too. It's just that for traveling, it's quite expensive.
Oh, it doesn't not come with the powder?
No, it doesn't. You have to separately buy one, which I did before.
But yeah. Shelly has to put it on every 6 hours.
Well, I just don't, because I just let it get oily. But at least when I get oily, it doesn't cling.
Yeah,
it doesn't like...
Okay, so I'm going to talk about mine. Mine is the Nars. This is the translucent crystal light reflecting setting powder. And it's a loose powder. It's super light and fluffy. And I just like to use my big round brush, and I put it right under my
under eye brush here.
It's Real Techniques huffing brush. What is it, huffing?
Wow. Huffing brush.
Buffing, Jesus Christ.
Okay, let's take a look at this word here.
Holy.
I actually went like huffing.
Why would it be a huffing brush?
No, look at the word.
It's buffing. It just got rubbed off.
Exactly. The bee got rubbed off, and now it's called a huffing brush. So.
Yeah, I was like, it is huffing.
I was like, huffing. I use this brush, but I don't really put force on it. I don't really put force on it. I just like use it, and then I dab it onto my under eye area, or I kind of swipe it gently. Mm-hmm. I really find that there's a big difference when the powder is on my face versus when it's not, because the concealer usually lasts around 2 hours without powder, but then after 2 hours, it starts to get a little bit crease. Well, because I have dry skin, so it's gonna sit into my creases, and then like when my dry skin, I don't know if any of you have dry skin when they have like little dots. I'll show you guys a close-up later where like there's little dots on my under eye, and that is like, you know, you have dry skin. So
wait, what little dots?
There's, don't you see?
You know, dim. Where do they come from?
I have
it
too.
Is it milia?
No, the dots only are here when I don't do my skincare completely the previous night.
They're kind of like dry patches.
They're dry patches. Oh. If I moisturize enough, then the dots don't appear. But last night, obviously, I just
I have
didn't.
That too, and I have your situation. I have your issue. I have everything.
I've never had that. That's interesting. Okay.
Yeah. So if you don't put the powder on, the concealer sits onto the creases and forms little dots, and.
Like, it clings to your dots.
Clings to my dots. Okay, so this is weird, because I have dry skin, but I have oily eyelids. So when I go through the day, I talked about this in my hooded eyes video, where the eye mascara and eye makeup eyeliner tends to leak down to the bottom here. If I put on this concealer...
It, like, transfers, right? Like, as you blink.
Yeah. If I put on the translucent powder, it doesn't transfer as easily. And I can get, like, 13-hour days without it transferring to the bottom. All of our powders are actually really good. They don't make the under eye or any area like so different in shade, because they're all translucent and they look natural.
Kind of like our skin, but better.
Dude, like sometimes I watch like those super glam makeup tutorials and they're just like
baking.
Just like,
not my thing.
And then you just say it, and then they leave it there, and then when you sweep it off, you can obviously see like a triangle.
And they do it here too.
Yeah, here and here.
Like it's to like carve out the contour or whatever, right? Yeah. We're just more like everyday.
Yeah. We're more everyday.
Yeah.
Okay.
Good Brex. Check it out.
Okay, so if you guys like this video. If you guys like this video, let us know if you want to see more.
Of our everyday products.
Yeah.
So we've done like everyday blush, my lips but better, like everyday lipstick. What else have we done? Everyday highlighters.
Everyday brow.
Everyday brow.
We can do an
everyday. We've never done everyday brow.
We've just done plucking brows. You did plucking brows. Mm-hmm.
Just let us know what you want to see.
Okay, bye.
Mm-hmm. Okay, bye.
Are we done?
Okay. Subscribe. Bye.
Lovely.
Bye.
Bye.